Good morning, everyone. And in this video, I'm going to teach you five simple ways to manage your raw images. Let's get this started. Welcome back, everyone. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you know when a new video comes out. Like I mentioned, in this video, I'm going to talk about five simple ways that you can manage your raw images. What is your process after you've captured the content that you're looking for? If I'm being honest, there's no perfect or right way to do it, but there are some best practices that you can employ to ensure that you're not gonna suffer data loss and you're set up for success with respect to your production. I'm gonna teach you some of the things that I do to manage all the content that I capture. Number one, and I've mentioned this before in a previous video, but what are you capturing on? Memory cards and the cards that you're using. For this recent production, I got to test drive the Panasonic S1R, and I got to review this camera a few months ago, so check that out if you haven't. Specifically with the S1R, there's an XQD card that's also utilized. So with this, unfortunately or fortunately, there's only premium options on the market. So we got something that's really resilient, really robust, and this is what we use. But whatever camera you are utilizing, be sure to invest in fantastic cards so you don't have anything to worry about at the point of capture. Listen, I talk about this a lot. Let's just move on to the second point. Number two, and this might be more of a mentality shift if you want to call it, but after your production, the number one priority needs to be backing up your content. Where is it going? It can't just stay in the card, in my opinion. So with respect to any production that I'm working on, the first priority is to offload it to a master archive of some sort. For me personally, it's this giant hard drive at home with tons of space that houses all my images, all my videos, and it's that one repository where everything sits. I know I have a copy of everything here. So with tip number two, again, it's all about making sure that once you've wrapped production, you are offloading to a master source of some kind where you know everything sits. Tip number three, and this one might seem redundant, but that's the goal. And that's to have a second copy of all your content in a different location where you'll be working from. Let me elaborate on this. So once we wrapped our production with the Panasonic S1R, we had these fantastic portraits that we shot. I copied everything over to my Drobo at home that houses everything. I then have a secondary drive where I move my images over, and this is where I'll be editing them from. It's a small portable drive that I can take with me. How you do it, it's up to you. Maybe it sits on your laptop or on your PC, but it is a secondary location that I'm working the edits from. This is where I'll be tweaking them, managing them, picking my favorites, and exporting them to the final destination. But it is independent of that master drive. The reason here is that you have a single source that is untouched, backed up, and not really being accessed as often, and therefore not putting as much mileage on, and you have a secondary location that is your working location. Again, tip number three, a separate secondary location where you'll actually be working on a separate copy of all your images. Tip number four, and if you disagree with me, let me know in the comments, but create an online backup of all your content. That master copy you have on that hard drive, find a way to have it backed up online. The idea of having a backup that sits in the cloud somewhere else independent of the hardware in front of you is great reassurance for your production. This idea where you can have all your content accessible, and in an event of a catastrophe, should I knock on wood for this? You know that you have a reliable backup that is independent of your hardware. For me personally, I use Backblaze. It allows me to back up my laptop as well as one connected drive in the background and give me the peace of mind that all my critical material is secure somewhere outside of my home. The last tip I want to talk about is, what is your culling process? How do you go through your images? What is your mentality? What are you looking for, and how many steps are involved? And listen, again, there's no perfect way to do this, and I'm not telling you that this is the way to do it, but for me, what I like to do is break this down into sizable chunks. Once I have all my images backed up, I'm ready to start working on them. So I bring them into my RAW editor of choice. The first thing I'm looking for is which ones are usable and in focus. And that's my first pass. And I bring it down to a sizable selection. Once that's done, I come back at another time with fresh eyes and start looking at composition. Now that I know that these images are in focus and they're usable and the exposure is not terrible, which ones actually have an interesting story to them? And I go through my images and decide which ones I'd like to use. And that's not all, I do one more refinement. Which of these images that remain tell the story the best? I go through and choose which ones really stand out and give the message that I'm looking for. And once these refinements are done, the process of editing just feels that much easier. Now that I know that all my content is backed up, and backed up again, and I have a secondary location where I'm gonna securely work on them from, and I've been able to cull them to the best images, I no longer have that taking any mental space. I get to work on them and explore my creative potential. But more importantly, let me know what your best practices are. How do you manage your files? How do you manage your workflow? And what are some tips that you'd like to share? I'd love to hear them in the comments below. Once again, my name is Gajan. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time.